technology risk management. So if we speak to our customers or if we speak to our partners and alliance partners, we can recognize a few use cases which are really, I would say, the core ones, so which really are relevant for most of them. One of them is technology risk management, and I think it's really relevant for all customers of us, and because risks occur in every company, regardless of size or industry, it's really relevant for everyone. So there are different types of risks that you need to separate in some way. So it can happen that your systems just get unavailable, that you face outages. It can happen that you get hacked from outside of your company. It can happen that your sensitive data falls in some external hands, and which you obviously would like to avoid. And it also can happen that you fail to be compliant with some regulations or with some laws. Regardless of which risks happen, the impact of those is always really critical for most of them. You can lose revenues, you can lose reputation, you can lose efficiency of your company. So whatever type of risks you are facing and or can happen, the impact of such, if they become, you know, if they occur, is really key and have a lot of, can create a lot of damage. What can you do to get such risks under control and really to take care that they don't happen and that they don't have really, if they happen, have a significant impact on your company? What everyone will say is, yeah, you just have to put a risk management process in place. Sounds easy, but it's not that easy as it sounds like. First of all, quite often people are reluctant to put such a process in place because they think, okay, in the past, you know, never happened anything, so why should I invest some money, some effort to do something about this? And so I think the first thing to really to get something in place is to create really some awareness of it and to make it really obvious, you know, what can happen, what will be the impact if something happens. And then the next step would be to define a risk management process, which covers usually those steps like a process for risk identification, for analyzing risks, for assessing the impact of the identified risks, and also process for taking actions. And last but not least, and this is also quite important, something for the end, to a kind of monitoring process that takes care that your risk management process gets consequently followed and that it also is efficient. Yeah, so the challenges when implementing a technology risk management process are, I would say, first of all, you need to get someone convinced really to do it. Because it's like in private life, if never anything happened, you know, you're not really willing to spend any budget or effort on this. So I think first of all, you need to get a sponsor and really someone who says, yes, I think this is important and I'm willing to support this and support that that we really do this. I think that's the first thing. The second thing when it comes to risk management is it's quite often seen as a really kind of technocratic, dull exercise. So people think, you know, it's a boring task, and you know, it's work about compliance and something that could happen, but you never know, will it really happen? So it's not so really so attractive. So it's also important to get people convinced about the importance of it and also show them that they are doing something really important. I think the third thing challenge with risk management is, as I said before, so risk management process starts with identification of risk. And to identify risk, you need to have lots of data. And also to evaluate the impact of risk, you also need, again, lots of data. And so this requires that you identify all available sources for data, that relevant data, and that you are able to, you know, to feed all of this data into one analytics system that provides you an overview. So, and that's a really a challenge, first of all, to identify all these data sources, also to consolidate the data and to get it in a format that is easy to read so that you're really able to analyze the data and to also to identify the highest risks and also to identify the impact of such risks if they occur. Last but not least, I think it's also a challenge for the people because risk management requires a good understanding of both sides of the coin. So you need to have a good understanding of the business, and you need to have as well a good understanding of the underlying technology. So, and really to get risk management to work, you need to understand both worlds in a good way. So to be able to understand what will happen if technology fails, what will be the impact on the business. And another thing just comes into mind. I think also there's also one aspect that is also quite important and which is quite often a challenge. There are different types of people involved. So on one hand side, you have people who are doing the analysis of the data and to identify risks. And on the other side, you have decision makers who really decide on the actions that need to be taken to minimize the impact of risk and to mitigate. And so those are two different types of people, and you need to find a way so that both type of people really communicate in a very good way. So you need to find a format that is understandable for both sides, and I think this is also quite often a challenge, at least from my perspective and based on my experience. So how can you overcome those challenges? I think, first of all, it's really important to get started. So to find someone who really believes in the importance of technology risk management and who is willing to support such an exercise. Then second step, I would say, is to define in a very well way required processes and procedures to perform risk management. So really for the complete process, starting from risk identification to risk monitoring. Afterwards, you need to think about some tools that will support this process. And you actually, I think you need for every process step of the proper tools. And it's not just about identifying relevant tools. I think it's also quite important to ensure that these individual tools play very well together so that they really get well integrated. So let's make it a little bit concrete. So for example, when it comes to risk identification, so I said before, so there are lots of data sources within a company who provide data that can be used for the risk identification. So it's important to collect all this data and to consolidate the data and to get it in a nice view so that you don't get lost in all this data. And here, for example, an enterprise architecture solution comes into the play game. As it is usually quite open systems that is able to integrate with individual data sources. This could be, for example, IT service management system. This could be a CMDB. This could be a monitoring solution. So there are lots of different sources that such a tool needs to connect with. And then the next step would be also to get databases integrated. For example, a quite typical risk type is related to outdated systems. So in many companies, of course, they have what they always call historical grown system environments. So they have got lots of legacy IT in place. And so they need to find a way that helps them to identify those outdated systems, those outdated applications and IT infrastructure components in an efficient way. An enterprise architecture solution, first of all, can help them to identify and to get a transparency about their IT components. And last but not least, also helps them to classify those systems in regards of their life cycle status. Such a solution like LeanIX, for example, includes a lifecycle data management solution and will show you in an overview in an IT component map, really, for each of the IT components, okay, what is the lifecycle status of such a specific IT component? Second example, so I said, okay, data management is also quite important for risk management. So you need to be able to identify sensitive data, and you need to identify as well those parts in your IT or those parts of the business that are using the data, so that you evaluate that you are able to evaluate the impact of data if data is not treated well, and so who will be impacted. For such an exercise, an enterprise architecture tool can help you, first of all, by giving an overview about which data objects are managed by which applications. So this is a quite typical task of an enterprise architecture solution for such data management. Beside that, it can help you with providing survey functionalities that supports you in reaching out to relevant stakeholders to get their view on data, to get their view on the data status, to get their view on the sensitivity of data and such things. Last but not least, another very important risk type is the unavailability of systems. So for such types of risk, enterprise architecture tools need to be able to connect to IT service management systems and need to show, you know, the amount of incidents that are related to a specific application or IT components. In a solution like LeanIX, this gets done with a matrix functionality. So, and the matrix will show you for each application or each IT components how many incidents did occur related to this application, IT component in the past. Is there any trend? Is this really an application which is quite kind of troublemaker or not? And so, and in combination with the business context of your reports, you can say, do I have any applications that are seen as really business critical, which are have lots of incidents? And if this is the case, for example, there is really serious risk related to such a specific applications. So in summary, I would say, if I should give a few tips about risk management, I would say, first of all, don't wait until a risk gets reality. So do something before it happens. Beside that, find a sponsor, really someone on a senior management level who understands the importance of this topic and who is willing to support the work on this topic. Certainly, I put a professional process in place that is based on best practices and common standards for risk management. And in the end, also find professional tools and solutions that support your process and take care that the process gets done in an efficient way and that it also gets done in a consequent way. And I would say this is maybe the really important aspect of risk management. Not just do it also consequently.